Expressionism. Hope you can all join us. Those of you who can't make it here, we'll give you a little preview. These two previews, The Guardian and Between the Lines, they're both in a series that I did called New Beginnings. I painted the first one called Transition because I felt like at that time, while I was painting Transition, that I was the one who was in transition. I felt that my art had taken a whole new direction, and I painted 9 paintings after Transition, one right after the other, knowing that my art was going to be changed from now on. These are 2 of my favorite paintings. The Guardian, I think it's self-explanatory. It's a kind of ethereal and impressionistic, but it's a guardian that looks over all of us. And in Between the Lines, this was a painting that was shipped on location in Florence, Italy, and it was to be on exhibit there, along with another painting called Transition. Those 2 are the ones that were sent. This painting has been sold, but this is called the Giclée. And for those of you who might not know what a Giclée is, it is a high-resolution photograph put onto canvas. And it's not the original, but I only do 1 Giclée if I'm going to do, if it's a certain painting that somebody would want. Then going over to this painting, called Begin Again, and Begin Again just sold, and it's being shipped to Jamaica. Begin Again has a little bit of a history, because Begin Again means that we start at the earth, and we go from the earth up to the seas, up to the atmosphere, to darkness, and to light, and then we begin again, just as in life. Moments is a painting that is exactly what it says it is. I had fleeting moments as I was painting this in all the different colors. I love the oranges and the reds and the yellows and the mixtures and that little bit of hint of black that just makes it snap and pop for me. And it's a wispy type of painting. And they're fleeting moments in everyone's life. This is a diptych, Counterparts 1 and 2. And in many of my pieces, they're mostly all abstract on large canvases done in oils. And it's just what I'm feeling at the moment. A lot of times I'll do a painting I know exactly the direction I'm taking. And other times I just let my mind wander and just try to be free in my studio with no interruptions. And this is what comes out of it. This is also on the cover of my new book. And that can be purchased at Barnes & Noble's. This is Masquerade. This is an earlier painting that I did in 2013. And it's one of my favorite artists is Wilhelm de Kooning. And I guess, you know, when I was told early on in college by my mentor, Al Sella, he said, "You paint like de Kooning." Well, of course, you know, that's not for real, but he said, "Do you know who he is?" And I said, "No, I have no idea who he is." But I learned pretty quickly who he was. And I can see some of the movements in there. But most of the times, you'll see in all of the paintings that we have here in the gallery that's on exhibition that every one of them is different. to adjourn. And most of my paintings, when I do them, I feel that I'm on a journey. And this one was perpetual, and it was painted in 2018. And this will be gifted to the gallery here at Pensacola State College that will be in perpetuity for this building and for their art. These two paintings are called Heart of the Matter 1 and Heart of the Matter 2, this being 1 and 2. These are just free-flowing and painting from the heart, which ends up being in this area of the painting and in this area of the painting, because it takes a lot of heart to do anything that we really love. And I love to paint, and so that's really why they get their names. Sometimes I can't come up with a name, but other times when I'm painting, it just comes out automatically. This painting is called New York, New York, and it is a special painting for me because Art Tour International magazine, which is one of the largest art magazines in the world, selected this painting and then selected me as Artist of the Year and received that award in Florence, Italy. So they took a portion of New York, New York, and it's on the cover of their magazines. I'm very proud to have received that honor and to have gone to Florence, Italy to receive it. Excursion. This is a painting I did also in 2018. And as I told you earlier, that when I'm doing a painting, it's a journey. And that canvas and those paints take me on a special journey. Sometimes I'm aware that I'm traveling. Other times I'm so engrossed that I really don't feel the journey until I'm almost finished with the painting. But this is a journey through life, as we all take journeys through life. This painting is called Beyond Reach. It was painted also in 2018. It's with most, like I do, bold and colorful, large canvases. It has some of the techniques of the lines that I use, but this painting, when I was doing it, it felt like when, you know, you release the balloons into the sky, you really don't know where they're going to reach, and how far and how high they're going to reach. And I guess I felt like, you know, I have an open space that I can reach any limits when I'm painting in my studio. This painting is called Spectrum because it really shows most of the colors of the spectrum. And it's one of my favorite paintings. And in it is mostly its color, its value, its design. And it's just a little bit of different techniques that I use. And I'm just happy because when it comes together, I always know when a painting is done, and I have a lot of fun with this painting. This painting is called Rhapsody. It was done in 2015, and Rhapsody was a painting that I did because I was going to enter a contest that was Jackson Pollock, but I never entered it. But doing this technique allowed me to explore and to try something different. But even though it is like a Jackson Pollock, it's also very much the techniques that I used and have used for years in my paintings. this painting journey was the second painting that I did in the series of New Beginnings. And I told you that we did 10 paintings in that series called New Beginnings. And when I started this, again, the word journey keeps cropping up through all of my work, because anytime you're doing something that you love or something that you're working hard at, you're on a journey. And so, therefore, this painting became a journey, and you can see the journey that I took. This is a special painting that I did, special to me, because it was in the Museum of Las Vegas with four other of my paintings. And it was quite an experience where I met artists from all over the world there. And the colors were a different palette for me. And if you can, so many people see different things in this painting. And I love to hear what they have to say to me about what they see. But what was seen and what I was feeling in this painting is Her Earthly Vision, the name of the painting. And if you can follow with me, this is the head. These are the shoulders. And this is the reclining figure that goes this way. And it's very oriental in nature. I did interior design for 30 years, and I would always add something that was oriental in a building or in a job that I was doing. And I think it was from my mother. She always loved, we were born in New York in the Bronx, all of us. And she would always love to go to Chinatown. And so I have many memorabilia of Chinatown and the things that she loved. But I was always interject something of the Oriental design. And I think it has that. And it has almost like the rice paddies and the landscape and the topography that you see sometimes in old master's paintings of the women out in the rice paddies and the men working. This painting is from the sea. And it's ethereal in nature. And it can be whatever you wish it to be. But as I was painting it, I wanted the three beings, and whether they were in the sea, rising out of the sea, going into the sea, it's anybody's guess as to, you know, what you want to see out of it. The darkness in the background of this composition is that, just that. It's a composition that I thought would be strong, because this is a strong painting, or meant to be a strong painting, and I just hope you like it. These two black and white paintings are impressionistic in nature, the top one being someone that just conjured up in my head, no particular person, and the name of it is Focus. I did two of these paintings that you're seeing here today, and two others in the series called the Black and White series. The second painting down below, I love animals, and sometimes I always interject animals into my work. And these, as you will see, are two elephants, but they are very impressionist done, and it's just representational of some of the technique that I use when I'm painting. And it was fun to do. I've done a lot of black and white, but these are four new ones that I've just completed. Over here, we have the very first sculpture that I did, Her name is Yesenia. She is Mexican and Nicaraguan descent. And I studied in a course with Dr. Gary Sussman in New York at the Art Students League of New York. And we went on to the Vitasil campus that they have there. And it's a sculpting course for a week. And she posed for us for an entire week. She was a fabulous model. And it is water-based clay. And it is a bronze patina. And I was hoping when I went to New York to study that I wouldn't like doing sculpture. But obviously, I fell in love with sculpture and don't get to do a lot of it like I'd like to because I love to paint as much as I love to sculpt. But I also ended up doing my second piece that I'll show you over here, which has a great deal of meaning for me. And this is a sculpture piece of my father, Max. And Max is done in a water-based clay, but then bronze. And Max, my father, sat for me for 2 weeks while I sculpted his bust of him. And I've said many times to many people that come into my gallery and studio that if I never was able to do another painting or another sculpture in my entire life, that I have the piece that means the world to me. With me in my art. I hope you enjoy it.